The void portal within Ulnar has been sealed, but a greater threat looms. Amon is transforming our people into a host form.
While we were focused upon Ulnar, he has unleashed the full might of the Golden Armada, using our own weaponry to eradicate life from planets across the Kaprulu sector.
Our current forces are not powerful enough to engage the Great Fleet, but Amon's other servants run rampant across the sector.
Then we should strike immediately. Eliminate his outlying forces.
The ancient purifiers were designed for war. If we reactivate them, we can build our armies and destroy Amon's Zerg broods in one fell swoop.
Assuming they do not turn on us first. The purifiers possess no loyalty, no honor.
You waste time bickering. The Tal'Darim's death fleets are your threat. I alone can challenge Malash for the right to rule and bend his army to my will.
Do not forget Mobius Corps. They are rumored to operate from a hidden base where they forge a hybrid army to serve, even now.
This is true, but we cannot engage them without knowing where they are. Vorazun, send your most elite Dark Templar to scour the sector. For now, Kerax, your focus must remain with the Keystone. The survival of our people depends on our actions in the days to come. It falls to the Firstborn to stop the coming Oblivion. The Zelnaga are dead. There is no salvation within Ulnar. And yet, we indeed found hope. If we are to fight, we must raise an army. Phoenix and I believe that we can awaken the ancient purifiers and call upon their power. They may have been a forbidden weapon, but I have seen their potential in Phoenix and know that this time, they will not fail us. I have made a decision many of you will not agree with. During my time with Phoenix, I have seen that the Purifier program, under the right guidance, may be reborn.
History has shown the Purifiers cannot be controlled, Artanis.
They do not have to be. These personalities, like I, will have free will.
We do not have enough Purifier matrices to create more like Phoenix.
You cannot possibly be considering what I think you are.
The original purifiers are housed in orbit above the forest world of Endion, sealed within their warship, Cybros. I have seen through Phoenix that these warriors may be valuable to us. Perhaps the Conclave misunderstood them, treating them as simple robots and not proud Templar. It tried to control them.
And they rebelled, attacking their creators.
Would you not rebel against a slave master?
I have heard your counsel, and I have chosen to go to Endion. We leave at once!
The Purifier stasis grid is still intact. We'll have to destabilize it from the generator below. I'm detecting a massive Zerg infestation on the surface. They can't be Kerrigan's.
Amon's brood. This will not be easy.
Hierarch, my scouts are tracking the movements of the Golden Armada.
What you plan to do is awaken monsters, Artanis. They slaughtered every Templar on the base of Lentinum.
They rose against their masters. Our people never treated them as Templar.
Because they are robots, created to do the bidding of the Conclave.
Is this what you think of Phoenix? A robot whose only purpose is to do your bidding?
He certainly defies expectations. He is more.
Perhaps. Perhaps the original Purifier robots will be too. If nothing else, think of their benefit to the war effort.
That is, if they choose to join us.
I believe in Phoenix. I am willing to take the risk.
The Zerg pose quite a problem. Disrupting the stasis grid was never going to be easy, and it certainly will be less so with Amon's brood attacking us.
We will hold them off long enough for your work, Kerax.
The scientists sealed away Cybros with a device called the Megalith. It is the key to disabling the station's stasis lock. Once the grid is down, we have to act swiftly and bring Cybros online or flee orbit. The might of the brood below is too great.
Leave the defense to me.
I know this will work, Hierarch. I know I can guide the Purifiers through the darkness that lies ahead. Help them accept what they are. I can convince them that they will not be treated as servants again.
Then it appears as if you have found purpose, brother.
Since awakening, I have been confused, directionless, uncertain of what I am, how I came to be. Now, things are clear once more. Fate has laid out a purpose only I can accomplish. It is exhilarating.
Yes, you embark upon a task that even Phoenix could not achieve.
Yet he would attempt it if he could. I have learned much from Phoenix's memories, and through them, I have come to know myself. I am Phoenix, but not. I am my own entity, and I take pride in this. The shield emitters on Indion must be disabled if we are to reactivate Cybros. The time to begin is now, Hierarch. Cybros, the vault of the Purifiers. It is fortunate that Amon's brood has been unable to penetrate its stasis grid.
I now have access to Endion's records. The stasis grid is sealed by complicated locking mechanisms. They can only be destabilized by a certain device, the Megalith. I'll begin recovering it now, so it may work on the locks.
It will need protection. These forests already crawl with Zerg abominations.
Then we shall clear them out.
If I may, Hierarch, this facility once developed powerful weapons for the Empire.
I have heard tale of the mighty Colossi, scaling cliffs, besieging enemies from afar. Let us see how they fare against the Zerg.
From that cave. If we fire on the rock formation, it will seal the opening.
is secure. Warp coordinates for our nexus point are locked. Kerax, activate the megalith.
Authorization in progress. The megalith should be ready shortly, Hierarch. We will monitor its status and alert you when it is online. The megalith systems will take a few moments to activate. It will be ready to move out soon. In the meantime, I've upgraded our robotics facilities to construct colossi. You can warp them in whenever you wish, Hierarch. The megalith should be finishing up shortly. We should ensure that we have enough forces to defend it.
Online. We must ensure it reaches the stasis locks safely.
Has reached the first stasis lock. It will be safe below the surface as it does its work.
Detecting Zerg movement. Warriors, ensure none reach our nexus point.
Thank you.
megalith is almost done with this lock. I would advise you to make preparations for its next move. Sensors show the first stasis lock has been disabled. The megalith is relocating to the next one.
We meet the enemy in battle.
Megalith has arrived safely at the second stasis lock. It shall be brought down shortly.
Interesting. I believe this facility used power cores of incredible size to provide energy for experiments. They should be hidden somewhere within these hills. If our warriors can destroy them, we can claim the solarite components within.
Grows narrow ahead. Crawlers! They're rooting on the ridge! Brace for incoming fire!
Stasis lock disabled, and the grid is now at 60%. The megalith is en route to the third lock now. first power core has been secured. Warping it aboard now.
Enough minerals.
This lock is almost destabilized. The megalith will relocate shortly. Both power cores have been obtained. I'll begin working on them immediately. The third lock has been disabled, and the megalith is on the move. My readout shows Cybros beginning to awaken from stasis. Only two remain, Hierarch. I am detecting a large number of Zerg bioforms in the cave network ahead.
We can use the terrain to our advantage. Topple the rock formations near the entrance, and seal the Zerg within the caves.
Attack.
good day to die.
It shall be so. Yes?
A significant number of Zerg have been detected in the caves ahead. Exercise caution.
It is a good day to die. It is a good day.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Phase link authorized. The megalith is now disabling the fourth lock.
It is a good day to die.
Where does my prey hide?
We are reforged.
It is a good day to die.
Engaging foe.
Lock destabilization is nearly finished. The megalith will disembark soon.
Attack.
The lock is down and the megalith is traveling. Stasis grid at 20%. Wait. I'm detecting activity in the Zerg hive nearby. They're reinforcing the last lock.
There is an entire Zerg hive cluster between the megalith and the last stasis lock. Our only option is to fight through it. Seismic disturbance detected. Nidus worms are inbound on your location.
Begins. Ready for battle.
Your allies are in battle.
Engaging foe.
under attack.
It is a good the battle begins. I stand ready.
The final lock is destabilizing. And the grid is down. We've done it. Cybros is free from stasis.
Recall our forces from Endion's surface. We take this battle to Cybros.
The Spear of Adun has finished replicating a new combat unit. You can assign it to a faction now if you wish.
I assume your plan is to bind these robotic warriors to your will.
They will be allowed their freedom, much like Phoenix. Making slaves of them is what led to their revolt before.
Oh, this foolish idealism taxes my patience.
Idealism? They are the replications of our greatest champions. We seek to free your people from Malash, and yet you desire to enslave mine?
I care not for freedom. It softens a people. I will dethrone Malash and save my kind from oblivion. But they will not be free. They will serve me. Freedom is a delusion granted to the weak by the strong.
You speak as Amon does. For the sake of your life, that will change.
Instill the Phoenix Machine as the new executor of the Purifiers, and use them as the tools of destruction they were built to be.
Why was Endion chosen as the world Cybros was to orbit?
For thousands of years, it has been a research retreat here, Protoss scholars secluded themselves from political affairs to focus on the task of devising technology that would benefit the Empire. The Psi Matrix was first conceived here. When it was decided that the Purifiers would be shut down, they became a symbol of achievement, but also the dangers of it.
So they were brought to a research colony.
Where better than a place where our greatest scientists resided, constantly improving Cybros' stasis field?
And how many resided on the world below?
800,000 Kalai, a contingent of Templar.
I only hope their deaths were swift.
We have received new robotic siege technology, Hierarch. Please make your selection.
Cybros will not be able to resist the Zerg for long. We should move quickly if we hope to save the Purifiers.
I require your honest counsel, Phoenix. Do you believe the Purifiers will join us?
I do not know. They may harbor rage, resentment for the actions of our forebears.
The Daylam is not the Conclave. We are united in purpose, like never before.
And that is why the Purifiers must be allowed to choose their fate for themselves. Without freedom, a people can be controlled, but never united.
This is true. And yet, the Firstborn have ill need of another enemy.
And I believe in you to not create one. Your actions determine the future for both the Templar and the Purifiers. But now is the time to act, Hierarch.
You are right. The way forward may be difficult, but it is necessary. Thank you, my friend. Your plan worked, Kerax. The stasis grid is down. We must act now.
If we can bring Cybros online, the battle station should begin to defend itself.
And the Purifiers?
They have lain dormant for millennia. They may still harbor anger towards us. If they turn on us, we will have to fight.
We failed them before, not understanding what it was we had birthed. These personalities may be replications, but they are alive.
After spending so much time with Phoenix, I share your belief.
With the stasis grid down, the Zerg have begun infesting the surface of Cybros. We do not have long if we wish to save the Purifiers. Your Templar. Tenacious as the Archives claim. Their infestation already spreads across the surface.
And Amon's hybrid has begun fortifying the Archives. We must hope for the aid of the Purifiers to win this battle.
Indeed. According to the station's schematics, Cybros' power architecture is divided into four distinct quadrants. Each is sealed by three null circuits. Destroying all of the circuits in a quadrant should restore its power, activating at least some of the Purifiers.
We will need to keep a watchful eye upon the core matrix. If the Zerg destroy it, Cyrus falls as well.
We should try to locate the null circuits as soon as it is safe to do so, Hierarch.
Artanis, there are unpowered cannons placed near the core matrix. With enough fortification, this would be a defensible position.
Listening. Identify our foe.
A Zerg force is preparing to move on the core matrix. Warriors, defend the core!
Grant me my end. As fate decrees.
We should head out and destroy the null circuits. The purifiers will attack the Zerg and slow their attacks upon the core.
Detecting a purifier awakening on its own. Wait, something is amiss. The AI has gone rogue.
Its solarite memory lattice has grown irreversibly unstable. We should disable it. At least we can put its solarite to use.
The fires of conflict burn bright. Command me.
Unto death.
Begun guarding the null circuits.
Zerg are attacking from the northeast. They're trying to break through our nexus point. I stand.
Attack. It must not fall.
Warrior awakens.
Thank you.
for the High Lord.
There, a null circuit. Destroy it, and power should begin to flow again.
The core matrix. Repel their assault.
Energy flow increasing exponentially. It's working. The purifiers are activating.
So shall I suffer.
I am Executor Clarion. I address the leader of the Firstborn.
Executor Clarion, your deeds are taught to all Templar, even to this day.
Cease your adulation. Why do you seek the purifiers?
Brothers, you were created to protect the Empire, yet we did not treat you as you deserved, as true Templar. I implore you to forgive our ancestors' mistakes, to take up your ancient charge once more, and join us as equals.
We will see if you speak truth. You will aid us in purifying this alien threat. Only then shall we discuss this further. Sentinels! Advance upon the alien stronghold! Purify the invaders! We meet the enemy in battle.
As the chain commands. Willingly.
High Red are moving to strike the core matrix. We must tighten its defenses.
To death.
Base is under attack.
It is a good day, Zutzai.
You have not enough minerals.
I stand ready. Kasar de Templari.
It is a good day to die.
Grant me my end.
It is a good day to die. It's a good day to die.
Ulas Atari.
It is a good day to die. It is a good day to die.
Base is under attack.
It is a good day to die. It's a good day to die. It is a good day to die. The skies beckon. It is a good day to die. Eyes to the horizon.
Firstborn, I remember. Betrayal. Death. Unacceptable.
Understood, Phoenix. I will see the Solarite is recovered properly.
Is under attack.
Willingly. I obey.
The skies beckon. What tunes horrid us? Ah, at last.
We meet the enemy in battle.
Is under attack.
You should be unworthy.
Let us attack. Ready for battle. The skies beckon. I stand ready.
My prey hide.
Thank you.
All circuits destroyed. Station at half power.
Purifiers! Our home is under assault by alien forces. Move out and eliminate them.
Enough energy. Base is under attack.
I would advise against attacking this hive cluster with our forces, Hierarch. This is the Purifier's purpose, after all. We should attack this null circuit. Destroying it will help us awaken the Purifiers.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy.
Mineral field depleted.
last grouping of null circuits is located here.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy. Is under attack. Mineral field depleted.
Must have energy.
Receiving. Confirmed.
Third quadrant is coming online now. Cybros is at 75% power.
Upgrade complete.
We meet the enemy.
Brothers, our time has come. Eliminate the alien bioforms with extreme prejudice.
Is.
The battle begins.
Seals are fully unlocked. Cybros is awakening. Hierarch, Cybros has reached full power, and the Purifiers are cleansing the station of the Zerg.
Fight on, brothers. Slaughter them to the last.
Wait! I've been disconnected from Cybros' systems. The core is activating. It's going to fire!
Commencing purification.
Signs disappearing. The surface of Endion has been cleansed of life.
It is over.
Phoenix, contact the Purifiers. I would speak to them. Executor Clolarion, you have awoken during the Firstborn's darkest hour. You have shown us that the Purifiers are a mighty force that could turn the tide of this war. I ask you now to honor your sacred charge as Templar, and fight beside your brethren as you did before.
You are no different than the Conclave. Once again, you try to control us.
No. I wish to make amends for our past failures. I have fought battles alongside one of you. Phoenix, the one you are linked with. The Conclave feared your kind. But they are no more. I know you are true Templar. I have seen it. I ask that we stand as one, or none of us shall stand at all.
I will counsel with the others.
They are deliberating.
If we are to follow, we would ask the entity Phoenix to speak for us. There is much about this time we do not yet understand. But as long as you hold to your word, Hierarch, the Purifiers shall join the Firstborn.
Hierarch, I have powered up a new ship subsystem. You can review it in the Solar Core now.
This errand of yours has been a waste of our time. We should leave for Slain.
The Purifiers will be a useful addition to our forces. I would hardly call this an errand.
Yes, but as we already discussed, you chose to give them freedom, hoping that they will do as you command.
Do not presume to lecture me about my decisions, Tal Darim.
But I so enjoy our exchanges.
Amon's presence within the Kala grows stronger. He is becoming harder to resist.
You risk much for this, Rohanna.
He believes all suffering, all conflict, results from the Xel'Naga's infinite cycle. That it must end.
Yes, he has made this clear.
But you see only the surface. Underneath, a silent hatred roils within him. A prideful resentment that would see all worlds burn. The hybrid are the true face of Amon. He wishes not only for the Xel'Naga's creations to be set aside, but for them to suffer. These Purifiers have joined our army, Hierarch. It seems they are willing to serve you. For now.
I answer the call.
Tannis, you are more than welcome.
I have been analyzing the Purifier bodies en masse. Their systems function more effectively when in proximity to each other. Outlying protocols can be offloaded to unoccupied cores.
What does any of that mean, Karax?
Their data web was designed to replicate the sense of the Kala. They are connected to each other.
Interesting.
Yes, however, it is a synthetic representation. There is no emotional wave.
The engineers who built them could not imagine how they could ever be seen as Protoss without the light of the Kala. If only our ancestors could see us now. Achieved an incredible feat, friend Phoenix.
Phoenix, I have been thinking more upon that name. It is the moniker of another. I do not believe I should use it any longer. I am not he.
Phoenix was the bravest warrior I have ever known. He faced terrible odds and emerged victorious. Slayed enemies, the likes of which most cannot even comprehend. And yet, you have proven to be of equal bravery. He would have been honored that a warrior such as you bore his name. And so am I.
Your words honor me, Hierarch. But one day, I must find my own path and my own name.